Good morning. Thank you for tuning in to Mount Pisgah Independent Methodist Church. Today's title is Make Your Election Sure. Again, thank you and have a blessed day.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Great and mighty is the Lord. He's great in all the earth. He's holy, he's mighty, and he's awesome. This is still the day that the Lord has made. We have come to rejoice and be glad in it. Welcome again to Mount Pisgah Independent Methodist Church, the Resilient Church. God said that we are supposed to be strong. He wants us to be mighty. He wants us to fight back, bounce back. God says we ought to be the type of people that overcome our difficulties quickly. Thank you so much, amen, for allowing us to come into your homes. Thank you so much for allowing this ministry, this pastor, this under shepherd to come in your vehicles. God definitely has a word for you. Amen. Before we get with the word, I just want us to set the atmosphere for the glory of God to dwell. There's something about when we give the Holy Spirit an invitation to come in, to rest, to rule, and to abide. So right where you are, can you just call on the name of Jesus? Can you just tell him, adore you, Jesus. We honor you, Jesus. Hallelujah. He loves to hear your praises. He loves to hear your voice. Hallelujah to God. We worship you, King Jesus. We are still in awe of you. God, you still blow our minds. God, you're still excellent. God, you're still mighty. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the sand. God, you're worthy. God, you're great. God, you're awesome. And on this morning, we take the time, we make the time to offer up a sacrificial praise. Oh yes, there's somebody that's got pain in their body. There's somebody that really don't feel like, amen, giving God praise. But on this morning, God, we're going to put everything on the back burner, and we're going to lift our hands to a holy God. We're going to lift our voice to a soon coming King, and we come to tell you thank you. Oh, thank you for all that you've done, God. We declare not to just give you lip service, but God, we're going to put works where our faith is. Oh God, we love you, God, and we thank you for being a great God. We thank you for being a caring God. Hey God, you cared for us, God, when we didn't care for ourselves. You held us in the hollow of your hand even when we fell short, and for that we tell you thank you, God. That no man brought me forth. You are the one, God, that sustained my life. Oh, you are the one that kept the deaf angels back. You are the one, God, that kept that accident from happening. And for that cause and for that reason, we come to tell you thank you. I don't need no organ. I don't need a tambourine. I don't need hand claps. The only thing I need is a memory. For when I think of the goodness of Jesus, that's the Son of God, and all that he's done for me. He's done so much for me in my 46 years of living, in your years of living. He's done so many great things for you. I can't tell it all, but what I can do is offer up a sacrificial praise. Why? Because he's worthy. Glory be to your name. Glory be to your name. We adore you, God. We thank you, God, just for who you are. Amen. We thank God for this solemn assembly. Another day that God has touched us and allow us, amen, to breathe the fresh air. Don't you know it's a blessing to be able to breathe again? Don't you know it's a blessing to be able to wake up in the morning and realize where you are and realize who you are? That's a blessing. Everybody can't say that. Oh my God. So we thank you, God, amen, for touching us again with the finger of love. And for that cause, God, we won't let you down, God. We'll let a dying world know that you are Lord of Lords. We'll let a dying world know that you still are King of Kings. Oh God, I know it's according to the way we live and the service that we give, but God, we decree and declare, God, when we leave from out of this service, service, when we leave from out of this worship experience, God, our lifestyle will be a gift back to you. The way I live, oh God, how I treat my neighbors, how I treat my enemies, oh God, we're going to give it back to you. We're going to offer up, God, a holy lifestyle right back to you. Oh God, we thank you. God, we thank you, and we love you, God. Hey, thank you. Thank you. Amen. This is October, the first Sunday in October. Amen. Worldwide, probably nationwide. Amen. We represent this as breast cancer awareness. Amen. And we thank God, amen, for him still being Jehovah Rohi. We thank God for him still being Jehovah Jireh. He is our healer. The Bible still says that by his stripes we are healed. So we salute. Amen. And we want to congratulate them that are survivors. And we want to continue to pray for them that are still suffering, amen, from this illness. There are so many different types of cancer, amen. But this we do know, amen, God can heal. Oh, I just felt the Holy Ghost right there. God can heal all infirmities. God can heal any sickness. Ah, he's able to do it. The only thing he needs is this. He needs the faith the size of a mustard seed. And the Bible says you can speak to your situation and it got to change. I need you to put that in the screen. Say, my situation got to change. My situation got to change. Why? Because I got faith. Why? Because I believe, Hashata, that if I supply the faith, that God will come see about me. God will come see about you right where you are. Hallelujah to God. So we want to congratulate them. We have several church members here at Mount Pisgah that are survivors of cancer. Amen. And we want to salute you and thank God, amen, that you're still being a survivor. Amen. And because you are a survivor, you have a responsibility. I'm talking to you. You have a responsibility to speak life in the lives of them that have some type of cancer. Amen. You got people got cancer of the mouth, cancer of the mind. Amen. Cancer of the ears. Amen. Cancer of the action. Cancer is anything that can come against your organs, amen, or something that comes to corrupt what God has given you, amen. So we thank God that you're going to continue to let your light shine and speak life to every cancer situation in the name of Jesus. We decree and declare that it's already done, amen. I want to thank God, amen, amen, as we go into the word. I want to thank God as we go into the word, amen, that, amen, I was blessed to be with my auntie Aristian and her husband Keith and my, amen, cousin, amen, Tyreek, amen. They will be leaving, amen, Hinesville, going back to Jacksonville. We just want to pray that God will give them traveling mercy, and we enjoyed the fellowship. We enjoyed the time that we had together, amen. There's something about love. There's something about showing love. There's something about letting love rule your life. Let that sink in for a little while. Are we allowing the love of God to rule and control our life? When you allow love to rule and control your life, there's nothing or there's no one that could come against, whoa, Jata, what God has for your life. Why? Because you got love, and God just so happened to be love. Amen. So let's continue to show love one toward another, whether someone wronged you or not, whether someone does something to you or not. Let's do what the Bible says. For God so loved the whole world, and you know how the world treat God, amen, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him, they shall not perish but have everlasting life. Hallelujah to God. Turn with me in your Bibles to Ephesians, the first chapter. Ephesians, the first chapter. God, thank you for this word. We thank you, God, for the assembling of your people, amen, at our virtual church and them that are here. Father, speak to our hearts. Help us, God, to understand the riches, God, of this word. Help us, God, to continue to hide the word in our hearts, that when sin come knocking at the door, God, we'll say, you're knocking, but you can't come in. God, help us, God, to hear your word and to put your word to action. We want to practice living this word every day of our lives. And when we err, I'm talking to all of us, when we fall short, God will be quickly to repent. We'll be quickly to say, God, I'm sorry. Create in me a clean heart and continue to renew the right spirit within me. Oh God, we thank you, God, for unstopping the deaf ears. Thank you, God, for opening the blind eyes. Thank you, God, for reclaiming the backslider even now. Whoever you are that's listening to this prayer and will receive this word, you never will be the same after today. I speak it and I decree and declare, you will never be the same after today. When I say the same, I'm talking about you're going to go forth in your divine purpose. We speak it, God, before we even see it. Thank you for giving us the faith to be able to speak those things that be not as though they were. God, we thank you, God, Lord. Help us, God, to continue to stand when stand is not popular. Father, bless these United States of America. Look on everyone, God, that has the COVID-19 coronavirus. You are a healer from the White House to the poorhouse. God, we speak healing in the lives of everyone, even 45, God, and his wife, God. Bring healing, God, till their life is our prayer. And it's in the name of Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. 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 We want to continue to lift up, amen, our members, amen, and non-members in the surrounding areas, them that we know that have, amen, been subjected with this Corona-19. Amen. We'll continue to keep Brother Murphy in our prayer. Anthony, amen. And we're always keeping our very own sister Tammy Dixon. Yes, we're keeping her in prayer along with her family. I think they got some new birth in their family. Amen. Their daughter, amen. We're going to continue to keep them in our prayers, amen, along with her pastor, my friend, hallelujah, Pastor Pinckney and his wife. You have it, Ephesians, the first chapter. Start at the first verse. Hear ye the word of God for the people of God. We're going to do some reading today, so just be ready. You'll be all right. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, to the saints are at Ephesus, and to the faithful in Christ Jesus, grace be to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Watch this. Who have blessed us with all spiritual blessings. It didn't come from man. Didn't come from you tearing at the altar. Didn't come from you, amen, wearing a prayer shawl. Didn't come from you getting tithes and offering. It came from heaven strong. It came from Jesus Christ. All spiritual blessings in heaven, places in Christ. Look at verse 4. According as he have chosen us in him. According as he has chosen us, not outside, but he's chosen us to be in him. When? Before the foundation of the world. That we should be holy. That we should be holy. He didn't leave anyone out. He didn't call your name. He said that we should be holy. Holy. The Bible said, be ye holy, for I am holy. Be is a command. Be is saying that I have already given you the tools. I have already given you everything that you would need to be what I call you to be. You already have what you need. It's at your fingertips. The Bible says, it's even nigh unto thy mouth. The Bible says, be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestined us unto the adoption of Jesus, of the children by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will. Verse 5 declares, we have been predestined to be adopted as children of the Most High God. God chose you before the foundation of the world to be holy. Yeah, he chose you. Even when you was a twinkle in the eye of your father and mother, God said, I chose you to be a part of my kingdom. That means you're special. God said, I have predestined you to be adopted, amen, in the life of Jesus Christ as children, because he said, it's my good pleasure. I want to do it. I desire to do it. I'm not looking at your ailments. I'm not looking at your flaws. I'm not looking at your waywardness. I'm not looking at your sometimey spirit. How many know some Christians have a sometimey spirit? Sometime they're up, sometime they're down. I tell you this, in these last and evil days, you better have more up days than down days, because don't you know you can lose your life in one of them down days. Hallelujah. Look at verse 6. To the praise of the glory of his grace, wherein he hath made us accepted in the beloved. Verse 4 declares that he has chosen us before the foundation of the world because he loves us. Verse 5 declares that, amen, before everything in this world was made and it was just God by himself, he said, I already predestined you to be my child by Jesus Christ. I want to park right there for a little while, Brother Tonio. It's so important that we know that the only way that we will have any type of relationship, the only way we would be, amen, spiritually hooked up to God, you got to go through Jesus Christ. You got to go through the blood. You got to go through Mary's baby. How in the world can you get to a holy God by yourself? And you're born in sin and shaped in iniquity. Ah, he gave us a remedy to that problem. He said, I will send myself through Heshata, through Mary, a virgin girl, and I will become the savior of the world. In order for him to become the savior of the world, he had to die. I come to let you know that you that under the sound of my voice, in order for you to be connected to God, to connected to the throne of God, you got to die. Oh yeah, you got to die to your ways. You got to repent and ask God for forgiveness. There got to be a funeral. I said there has to be a funeral. Something got to die in order for you to produce everlasting life. Amen. Follow me. Amen. Please follow me. Verse 5 says you were predestined to be a child of Jesus Christ. It was his good pleasure. Verse 6 declares, amen, he's made us accepted into the beloved. Amen. And here we have at verse 7, in whom we have redemption through his blood. Before you have ever sinned, before you have ever erred, before you have ever made a mistake, and as believers and unbelievers, we will make mistakes. He said, in whom we have redemption through his blood. Hey, the trap that you're in, the situation that seems tight that you're in right now, God said, I has already given you a way of escape. Amen. I hear the Holy Ghost saying, some of us are in issues, some of us are in dilemmas, some of us are in problems because we choose to be. You choose to be in that tight. Yeah. You choose to be in that turmoil. You choose to be in that jail cell. God said he has given man power. Power to make a choice. God said, my choice for you is for you to be redeemed. That means he took in what you are and he made you special. That means he's took in what the devil had planned for your life and he canceled his plan and he made you great even in the eyes of your enemy. So you are the redeemed of God through his blood. Somebody need to type on the screen, if you accept it. If you accept it, that's a choice. If you accept it, if you accept to be the redeemed of God through Jesus Christ, you can have it. It belongs to you. In whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of his grace, wherein he have abound toward us in all wisdom and prudence, having made known unto us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure. That's the second time he said good pleasure and his good will. According to his good pleasure, which he hath, amen, possessed in himself. Hey, watch this. This is about to get exciting right here. That in the dispensation of the fullness of times, he might gather together in one all things in Christ. I don't know how you can live a life without Christ. Sister Sonia, I don't know how you can live holy without Jesus. You need a Savior. You need a Redeemer. Amen. You ain't get this far by yourself. We sang a song, say, I come this far by faith. Well, where you get the faith from? Amen. The Bible say God has given unto every man a measure of faith. So where you are, you didn't get it, amen, by there by yourself. You got there, amen, by the faith, amen, that God has already given you. Yeah, you thought you did it on your own. No, sir, no, ma'am. The Bible says that in the dispensation of the fullness of time, he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and are on earth, even in him, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance. The only way you can receive an inheritance, Lee, Lady Pharaoh, somebody got to die. But we as believers, we have obtained, we have inherited an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of him who worked all things after the counsel of his own will. Goodness, it gets so good, I got to move on. That we should be to the praise of his glory. How are you living your life that your life should be to the praise of God? Are the things that I'm doing, the words that I'm speaking, the places that I'm going, the situations that I allow myself to be in, are they giving praise and glory to God? Are they giving praise to God? Look at your life. Look at where you were yesterday. Look at how you're talking about people yesterday. Look at, amen, the situation that you find yourself in. I know, amen, bad things happen to good people. But the Bible says that he has given every man, amen, a measure of faith. And with that faith, you have to learn how to build upon your most holy faith. Can I get a witness in here? Hallelujah. Look at 13. It's our last verse. In whom ye also trusted. In whom ye also trusted, after that ye heard the word of truth. The Bible says faith come by hearing, hearing come by the word of God. You were chosen to be redeemed. You were chosen to be in the royal family. You were chosen to walk according to his purpose. Verse 12 says you were chosen that you should be to the praise of his glory. Your lifestyle should be praising God. Let me tell you this, amen. If your lifestyle is not pleasing God, you ought to have the spirit of David to quickly repent. When you find yourself in error, you ought to lift up holy hands and say, Lord, I'm sorry, creating me a clean heart and get this junk filthiness out of me. That's all sin is filthiness, amen, transgression against God's law. Listen to this. In whom ye also trusted after that ye heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also after that ye believe. After you believe. After you believe. You got to believe first. After you believe. Amen. About 2 weeks ago, amen, something happened in society that never happened. Our very own, I say our very own because I feel connected to him, our very own Deion Sanders. Amen. He's a Hall of Famer. Amen. He got about 3 Super Bowl rings. Amen. But by 2 or 3 different teams, he agreed to become the head coach of Jackson State University. That's a HBCU. Amen. Historically black college. Amen. But one of the things that I picked up in his acceptance speech, amen, little mama, I picked up that he said, we believe. He said 2 words that I picked up on. He said, Sister Tiffany, we believe. It stuck out to me because he could have easily said, I believe. But because he changed hats and he began to be, amen, accept the position as a coach, he wanted everyone in his camp, he wanted all the kids that were in Jackson State and that were planning on coming to Jackson State, he wanted to impregnate them with this: we believe. We are family. If I believe, you believe. That stuck out to me real good. So the Bible says in verse 13, in whom you trusted after that you heard the word of truth. It's the gospel. What are you hearing? The gospel of your salvation. After that you believe. So you got to believe first. That's a qualification. That's your first qualification. You got to believe. Before you believe, you got to hear something. What are you hearing? And what are you hearing? And what are you doing after you hear it? So once you hear the word and you believe the word, watch what God did for you. The Bible says you were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. It belongs to you. It's yours. The Bible calls it, you know it, Paraclete. He's the one that walks on side of your spirit. He's your leader. He's your guider. He's the one that brings things back to your remembrance, because we like to forget things. He's the one that walks on side of your spirit. He's a gentleman. The Bible says in Revelation, behold, he stands at the door and knock. If any man will hear his voice and open the door, God say, I'll bring me and the spirit. We'll come in. And when Jesus come in, he say, I'll come in and sup with him and you with me. What that means is this. When you're empty, Brother Antonio, he said, if you open the door, I'll come to give you strength. Amen. If you're tired of living the way you're living, if you just hear the knocking at the door and believe and open the door, he said, I'll come in. And when God come in, he come to bring gifts. He come to bring power. He come to bring substance. He come to bring energy. He come to bring everything you need to live this life holy and acceptable unto God. Hallelujah. The Bible says, which that is your reasonable service. Hallelujah. If you can pick it back and look at verse 4. Amen. I want to get my theme out of verse 4. The Bible says, a calling as he have chosen us in him. He has chosen us in him. Who chosen us? Yeah, we just read it. He has chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy, that we should be holy, and that we should be without blame before him in love. I would like to speak, amen, for the next 15 and a half minutes. Amen. Make your election sure. Make your election sure. That's four words. Make your, make is a process. Make means something has to be done. Something has to pull two types of things together to form one idea or one substance. Make your personal election sure. Thank you. I know we're coming up, amen, around November 11th, amen. Many of us, amen, are going to be standing in the long lines, amen. And we're going to have to cast our ballot. We're going to have to make a decision, amen, which president that we choose to follow, which president and vice president that we choose, amen, to say, I agree in what they believe in. I agree in some of the policies that they stand behind. Well, you got to pick a side. Yeah, you got to pick a side. I know they're not the best sides. I know you'd rather see someone else running for it. Amen. But these are the two that we have to choose from. And it's so important and it's so imperative that we use the power that our ancestors, amen, allowed us to afford us this right to be able to vote. Amen. As a pastor, I won't tell you who to vote for. Amen. Hear God. Let God speak to you. Let the Spirit of God unction you on who you should vote for. But what I am coming to let you know, that you must make your choice. You must make your election sure. You got to know. You got to know. You, just like God knew that before the foundation of the world, he chose you. The Bible said, amen, before the foundation of the world, he chose you to be holy and without blame before him in love. Who will you choose? Who will be your choice? The chosen still have to choose. You're the chosen of God. You're the elect of God. But who will you continue to choose? Every day that God touch you with the finger of love and he allow you to breathe his fresh air, you have to make a choice. You have to make an election, which is a choice, to God, for this day and on this day, I'm going to live for you. Every day as Christians, no matter how long you've been saved, how short you've been saved, every morning you wake up and God give you power to get out of the bed, you have to make a choice on whom you're gonna serve. It starts early in the morning. I say it starts early in the morning. That's why the Bible say, amen, that Jesus got up a great while before day, and there he prayed. He consulted with God. Because as you go through your day, you better believe that your Christian walk, your Christian devotion is going to be tested. Oh yeah, your life, your belief will be tested. That's why it's so important that you make your election sure. Amen. There's another, amen, I meant to bring it with me, but I forgot to bring it. Over 2 months ago, I received some information in the mail, and when I opened it up, they wanted me to vote early. How many know you can vote early? How many know you didn't have to go down and stand in the line coming November 3rd? Amen. You can get your ballot through the mail and pick who you want to be in the council, who you want to be president, who you want to be in, amen, on the Supreme Court and things like that. You can make a choice now to make your election sure. That brings me to a spiritual point that God just gave me. I ain't had it wrote down. It came through email. It came through Bluetooth. Thank you, Holy Ghost. God said, you need to give me your life early. You need to submit your life to me early. What does early mean? When I unction you, when I touch you, when you hear the word of truth, that's when you ought to make a choice. Young people, you ought to give your life to Christ now. If you're at the age of accountability, some say 12, some say 7. These kids these days, they 4 years old. They 2 years old. They know what they're doing is wrong or right. So it behooves us, amen, to vote early. Make your election sure early. Because who's to say you make it to November 3rd? That's natural. But who's to say you make it on tomorrow? Tomorrow, the Bible say, and promise to you. I know I'm screaming, but I can't help it. Screaming in me. Hallelujah. Who's to say you will make it to see tomorrow? So if you're on this virtual church, if you hear what Pastor Farrell is saying to you, choose ye this day whom you're going to serve. If God be God, then serve God. But if Baal be Baal, that's any kind of idol God, your husband, your wife, your kids, your shirt, your shoes, your bank account, whatever it is that you some kind of way put before the will and the word of God. If Baal be Baal, then serve Baal. But you got to know, when you make a choice to neglect God, when we make a choice not to make Jesus Christ the Lord and Savior of our lives, we got to be prepared to suffer the consequences. I said we got to be prepared to suffer the consequences. Amen. Listen to this. As we learn to unlearn some things, we must decide to grow even when we leave the understanding of others behind. I'm going to read that again because 99% of y'all didn't catch it. As we learn to unlearn some things, let me stop right there. Ever since I grew up, I've always been a Democrat. That's all I knew. Amen. Until I got some knowledge about the Democrats. That blew my mind. I said, wow, I didn't know the Democrats started this. I didn't know the Democrats, amen, wanted to keep us in bondage. There's some things that I had to unlearn. There's some things as I learned, I had to think about, and I had to say, you know what? I need to make up my own mind on what I'm going to do and who I'm going to vote for. Can I get a witness? I hear some of y'all spirits say, Pastor, you voting for? Don't worry about it. Don't worry about who I'm voting for. Okay, I vote for Jesus. How about that? Huh? Make your vote count. I vote for Jesus. That's my vote. Hey, that's the spirit realm. But naturally, you know who I'm voting for. But you got to understand this, natural and spiritual. Come on. As we learn to unlearn some things, we decide to grow. That's the only way that you're going to grow naturally and spiritually. You got to be persuaded by your own mind. Can I get a witness? You can't let nothing or no one persuade you on how you should live unless you make that choice. When you allow other people, amen, to coerce you, to lead and guide you on how you should think, what you should wear, how you should live, you become a robot. You relinquish your right to have free will and a free choice. So God told me to tell you this, amen. As we learn to unlearn some things, we decide to grow. Everybody not going to agree with what you unlearn. Everybody not going to agree with what you change in your life. My mom and daddy raised me like this. But now you are at the age of accountability. You got to make a choice. As we learn to unlearn some things, we decide to grow. Even when we leave the understanding of others, there's some choices that you're going to have to make in your spiritual walk, in this natural life. You're going to have to leave the understanding of others. They're going to be scratching their head and saying, why did he do that? Why did he get that job? Why did he go with her? Why did he divorce her? Why did he marry her? Why they bought that car? Why they decide to have another child? Let me tell you something. We cannot live our lives, amen, for other folks. We have to say something else. We got to make sure we're living our lives for us. You can't live for other folks. People ain't got no heaven nor Hades or hell to put you in. Amen. People will crown you today and drop you by lunch. Usually I say tomorrow, but they'll drop you by 12 o'clock noon. They did Jesus like that. Hallelujah. Make your election sure. God made it easier for us in the book of Ephesians to let us know, I've already chosen you. Now the only thing you got to do is choose me. But when you choose me, look at what the Bible says in 2 Timothy 3 and 12. 2 Timothy 3 and 12. Ooh, glory to God. Time moving. 2 Timothy 3 and 12. How many know when you in Christ? Amen. Time is not a factor. I'm aware of time, but time don't move me. Time don't change me. Hey, I just love to be in this presence. I love to be around people that are growing in situations that allow me to grow. I say I love to be around people that are growing. People that are millionaires. People, oh, come on now. People that got more than enough. If you hang around them, someone that'll jump off on you. And we'll learn how to unlearn some things in your life that will progress you to a closer walk with him. Listen to this, 2 Timothy 3 and 10. It says, yea, and all that will live godly. Once you make a choice, once you have made your election sure, what is your election? I elect Jesus. I choose Jesus. Do you have a choice? Yes. You can choose heaven or hell. You can choose good or evil. You can choose righteous or unrighteous. You got to make a choice. But know that when you make that choice, the Bible says in Ephesians, don't forget about that, the 13th chapter, that I seal you with the Holy Spirit of promise, Paraclete. That's what's going to take you and make you to live a life pleasing in the sight of God. When I say make you, I don't mean go against your will. I mean there are some things that you haven't experienced. There are some habits. There are some disappointments. There are some things that you're going to go through in your life that's going to make you, that's going to produce in you, that's going to bring you to the fulfillment in your life that you will be able to give God a yes. I ain't always gave God a yes. I'm in the process. I'm being made. I heard a brother read the scripture. He said, keep me on the potter's wheel. Please, Jesus, keep me on the potter's wheel until I won't no more. Yeah. And all that will live godly in Christ Jesus. Your lifestyle got to be godly. Yeah, but don't forget about in Christ Jesus. We got a remnant of folks, Brother Tony, yo, they live godly, but they ain't living in Christ Jesus. There's no way you can live straight to God. There's no way you can pray straight to God. There's no way you can get your sins remitted by praying straight to God. You got to go through the filter. You got to go through the blood. At the blood of the Lamb. If you don't go through the blood, your sins won't be remitted. He won't forgive your sins. So the Bible says, all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. I'd rather suffer for Christ's sake. I'd rather have him roared for Christ's sake. Amen. I'd rather have COVID-19 for Christ's sake. I'd rather have anything in this world. But as long as Christ don't leave me. Eshata. As Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they decided, amen, to worship God. They decided to allow the Lord of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob to continue to be their God to the point that they got thrown in the fiery furnace. But they held on to their faith. They say, we believe. I think Deion Sanders was in there with them. They said, we believe that the God we serve, he's able to deliver us. And even if he don't, Eshata, he's able. Somebody need to type that on the screen. My God is able. Oh yes, my God is able. Say it and make the devil out of a liar. My God is able. Mm-hmm. That's faith talking. That's work talking. My God is able. Oh, glory be to God. In this world, you're going to have persecution. You're going to suffer persecution. The Bible says that we have to learn how to count it all joy, the book of James, when we fall into divers temptations. Once you make your election sure that for God I'll live and that for God I'll perish, know that God will be the one that will give you insurance. Look at somebody say assurance. Yeah, he won't give you insurance. God will give you assurance. What is the assurance? That if I make my election sure and I surrender my life to Christ, I abandon my evil ways. What is my assurance? Your assurance is the word of God. Your assurance is John 3:16. For God so loved the world. Great time of day. That's an assurance right there. If you had a Bible and that's all it had in it, that would have been enough. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. What you see in that is three of them. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. God bless Sister Shirley Brockerton. I learned that from her. God bless her. In those, that one verse, you see God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. You see God, you see Jesus, and you see love. I'm reminded in the book of James. Write this down. James 1:8. James 1:8. In order for you to make your election sure, you can't get to the polling place. You can't get to your early voting and be undecisive. As Christians, we must make a decision. We must have a concrete mindset in where and who we're going to live for. I say concrete. That means strong, stable, tough, unmovable. James 1:8 says this. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. You got to make sure that if you're going to make Christ your election, you got to make sure you don't have a wavery mind. Because a double-minded man will say, God, I love you. And before lunchtime, he'd be smoking a Newport, sleeping with somebody, drinking, getting drunk, and stealing. Great time of day. Hallelujah. You can't be double-minded. You got to have a concrete mind. When you have a concrete mind to say, God, I love you, and I'm going to receive your Holy Spirit that's going to lead and guide me in all truth and understanding. Listen to this. God gave me some nuggets. Amen. We're getting ready to close in a little while. Don't let the way you live say you're going back on your election to follow God and godliness. Don't let the way you live say this, I'm going back on your election to follow God and godliness. You say one thing, but your action is saying something else. That's all that's saying. If God is going to be your choice, is if holy Christian living, that means loving your enemies, that means doing good to them even though they persecute you, that means following after God's purpose for your life, saying, God, not my will, but let your will be done in me. I got to go to the cross. Lord, let your will be done in me. God, I got to give up my vehicle. God, let your will be done in me. God, I like this job. I got to leave. Let your will be done in me. Ooh, God, I really love that lady there. Let your will be done in me. We can't allow nothing in our lives to interfere with God's divine purpose in our life. And it's a good thing. It's a joyous thing to follow after God's voice. The only thing, brother, that makes it difficulties is when we got our own will. When we want to do things the way we want to do it. Amen. You won't even work at Burger King and you want to have it your own way. You can't have it your own way. You got to know this. Amen. It's a joy to live according to the word of God. That's what gives me joy. Hallelujah. Listen to this. God gave me this. When we allow our current issues to influence our choices, When you allow your current issues to influence your choices, we set ourselves up for a long-term dilemma, a long-term problem. Only thing that's saying is that the choices that you make now, if you make the wrong choice, it'll affect you not tomorrow, not next month. It can affect you all of this year and maybe next year. That goes me to a point. I heard a young man talking on the internet, and he said, do you know that since our president has been in office, he has elected 198 judges, two or three in the Supreme Court and other judges in the smaller courts. 198 judges. And the judges that sit on these seats, they're long term. Supreme Court is forever until you die. But the other judges, they are long-term sentences. So even if this president don't get another term, he has already set this world up. He has already set this world up for the rest of your life. Not to have control, but to try to change the narrative. That goes me to say, amen, the choices that you make now, if you allow them to influence you and change you, you can set yourself up for a long-term disaster or a long-term dilemma. Make a choice now. Make your election sure. Don't be double-minded. God has given you a way of escape, and it's through Jesus Christ. Listen to this. As people, we get tired of ourselves. I know why I did that one. As people, we get how many of you get tired of yourself? Y'all never get tired of yourself? You never made a mistake and say, God, I did that again? I broke my cell phone again? Huh? I left my keys in my car again? I left my lunch on the counter again? How I do that? Sometimes you get tired of your own self. As people, we get tired of our own selves. So at times, you're going to get weary of other folk. That's a part of life. I don't care if you're in a marriage. I don't care if you're on a job. I don't care if, amen, whatever type of situation you're in. If you get tired of your own self, don't you think you're going to get tired of some people around you? I'm saying that to say this. Just because you get weary of other folks around you, you got to be careful that you make your election sure. You got to make sure that you make the right choice. Not to speak ill of that individual, or not to treat them in a manner that you don't want to be treated. Y'all remember the golden rule? Do unto others as you have them do unto you. That's the golden rule. So if you get tired of yourself sometime, I don't say you don't love yourself, but every now and then you be like, you know what? I know better than this. Great call. At times you're going to get weary of others. But don't let your weariness of what others do affect how you treat them. Amen. Listen to this. Does the choices you make help you to operate in your purpose? Do the choices that you make, we all make choices every day. Some of us make 10,000 choices a day. You can't name them all. But do the choice that you make help you operate in your purpose? In your calling, what you're called to do, who are you called to effect, who are you called to love? But they don't love me. Who are you called to give alms to? I told a guy one day on my job, I said, sometimes we don't give alms or help folks because we feel like they're getting over on us. We feel like if I help them, what they doing for me? Well, ain't about you right now. You got to learn how to sacrifice sometimes. They not getting over on you. You following after the word of God. That's what the judges and the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they thought they were doing. Oh, we got one right now. We getting ready to crucify him. They thought they had Jesus. They didn't have, they was following, they was fulfilling the scriptures. Jesus even let Judas follow him. He was the fulfillment of the scriptures. How you gonna let a thief or the robber or the person go get money behind your back, 30 pieces of silver? How you gonna, you supposed to be Jesus. You ain't know he was gonna come against you? Jesus knew. Hey, Shatai, But the scriptures had to be fulfilled. I don't know who I'm talking to, but many of us are going through things and obstacles in our lives. God just setting you up. What God is saying to you, go through and just hold on. I know the end of the thing. Yeah, you're looking at what you in. You're trying to judge your current situation. But God says, my ways are not your ways. Neither are my thoughts your thoughts. As high as the heaven is from the earth. You can't touch this when it comes to God. Great God. Huh? We can't touch this. Hallelujah to God. Make your election sure. Somebody need to write this down. We must learn to communicate honestly. Woo. We got to learn to communicate honestly. Be honest. In the election that's coming up, I'm being honest. I don't want to vote for none of them. People say the best of two evils. Well, when it comes to holiness, there's no evil. When it comes to life we live, we should expose evil. We're supposed to resist the flesh. So I really don't want to vote for any of them. But in order for me to have a voice, I got to vote, and I will vote. I won't let my vote fall on deaf ears. I won't allow my ancestors, my brothers, my sisters, amen, who paved the way, who are trailblazers, to shed their blood, and I don't take advantage of voting. Now, when I'm talking about voting, I'm talking about mayors, I'm talking about city council, I'm not just talking about the president. Because when we vote in the city limits, those are the laws that rightfully affect us right then. So don't get it twisted, amen. Our ancestors just didn't die for us to vote for the president. You got to vote for city mayors. You got to vote for county commissioners. Those are the people, amen, that affect where you live at. You got to do your homework and learn how to get the proper people in proper places. That's going to help you excel in life. How many of y'all want to excel? How many of y'all want to go for? Maybe you want to be down. Maybe you always don't want to have money. Great God, not me. Hallelujah. Listen to this. We're getting ready to close. That's my second time. If your affiliation and your relationship is not ultimately making you better. If your affiliation, y'all know, understand what that means? If your relationship is not ultimately making you better, pulling greatness out of you, why stay? Why suffer yourself? Why die while you exist? Look at the current situation we in. Police reform. How many know we need police reform? Going natural now. How many know we need things to change concerning black and brown people? How many know we need some laws to be changed, amen, by allowing all of these companies to move in our neighborhood? Chinese restaurant, liquor store, amen. Chinese restaurant and liquor store, amen. Then a gas station, then another Chinese restaurant and a liquor store. What, great God. I'm dabbling now. If your affiliation and your relationship is not ultimately making you better, you got to make the ultimate choice. You got to make your election sure. Hababo shata, halobo, glory to God. I hear you, God. And sometimes you got to cut the biblical cord. Sometimes you got to, hey! Sometimes you got to separate yourself from a group of people, a posse, a clique. Hallelujah. There are a lot of things that I don't agree with that's in the Democratic Party. But I have more things that I agree with in the Democratic Party than I agree with in the other party. Can I get a witness? But brother, I know this one thing, that Jesus is my Lord. Huh? He's my Lord. He's my Savior. He's my overseer. He's the one that I answer to. I know I got to pay taxes, but as far as my spiritual walk, I choose Jesus. God has given every man a power of choice. What have you chosen? Back in the day, they used to have the ballots where you pull the handle, but you don't pull no handle. They went from pulling the handle to marking it with a pencil to now the only thing you gotta do is hit a button. It's advancing. Now, next is gonna be to a point you don't have to leave your house. Oh, I'm sorry, you don't have to leave your house now. Huh? Everything going through the mail. Everything going electronically. Hallelujah to God. Hallelujah to God. God say that's it. Joshua 24 14 through 21.
Can you read that in your spare time if you have time, if you love the word of God? Joshua 24, 14 through 21. Very powerful passage of scripture. It'll speak to where you are. Hallelujah to God. Joshua 24, 14 through 21. It's Sunday. You ought to read your Bible on a Sunday. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah to God. We bless your name, Jesus. We bless your name, Jesus. Help us, God, to make sure we're living up to the choices that we make. Help us, God, not to abandon who we affiliate ourselves with. Help us, God, to never be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Help us, God, to wear this world like a loose garment. Help us, God, is our prayer in Jesus' name, that we make sure Jesus will continue to be the Lord of our lives. For we are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Father, we need your help. Yeah, we vote. God, we've been voted for you. You are our King. You are our Lord. But help our lifestyle to line up to the election that we chose. Father, we thank you for this solemn assembly. We thank you, God, for them that have heard your word. Father, baptize us afresh through your word. Father, help us, God, to seek you early. Help us to vote for you early. Yeah, the world has early vote. God, I hear you saying we need to choose you now. Choose ye this day whom ye gonna serve. If God be God, then serve God. Father, we thank you, God, for them that have heard your word. Father, we thank you, God, for them that have dissected your word and, oh God, accepted your word to make them better, to grow them where they're supposed to be. Help us, God, to love everyone. Help us, God, to do good even to them that mistreat us. Father, help us, God, to excel, God, in our ministry. Help us, God, to catapult ourselves, God, to the word that you have impregnated in us, that our lifestyle will be a light to others. Not just our light, our lifestyle, God, but the way we talk, the way we move. Let it be an encouragement to everyone. And it's in Jesus' matchless name we pray. Amen. Amen. If you're there online, if you don't know who Jesus is and the pardon of your sins, we should never end service unless we give someone an opportunity, someone a chance to make Jesus their choice. I've been preaching about make your election sure. Well, now is the time. You can lift up holy hands, Hashekolobosha, and you can say, I'm giving Jesus my heart. I'm making a choice to choose good and not evil. I'm making a choice. I'm making my election sure to choose light rather than darkness. I'm tired and sick and tired of living the way I'm living. I'm tired of lies, tired of cursing. I'm tired of going waywardness. I'm tired. I want a change. I want a new direction. I want a new direction in my life. I want a new love. Huh? Lord, how old gosh, Lord, if that's you, my brothers and sisters, can you just lift up both hands and begin to say, Lord, I love you. Come on, lift. Hey, Hoshe Kolobosha. Don't think it's strange. Amen. God died for you. Just lift up both hands. Lift up your spiritual antennas. Say, Lord, I love you. Lord, I adore you. Save me, Lord. Fill me with the Holy Ghost. I repent of my sins. Forgive me of my sins. Fill me with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Teach me through the power of your word to live holy and acceptable unto you. Lead me, Father, to a Bible-believing church that preached Jesus, that preached the cross, that preached the resurrection. If you prayed that prayer, God has already written your name in the Lamb Book of Life. The only way that happens is you got to repent, ask God for forgiveness, and recognize, hallelujah, where salvation comes from. It comes from Jesus alone. Father, we thank you, God, for them that have prayed that prayer. Continue, God, to impregnate them with a spirit of hunger and thirst. Give them, God, to search the scriptures, God, because in them, you said, God, they'll find the issues of life. Father, go before us continually and continue to go behind us. Lead us and guide us in all truth and understanding. If there's anyone that would like to be a blessing to this ministry, we have three ways that you can give. You can give through Cash App, you can give through Givelify, or we have a P.O. box. Amen. There it is on the screen there. Hallelujah. $ Mount Pisgah Clyo. Hallelujah. Givelify, Mount Pisgah Independent Methodist Church, and the P.O. box, P.O. box 5, Clyo, Georgia. Hallelujah. Amen. If God will press upon your heart to give, you can give as unto the Lord. I wouldn't let, amen, this day go by. I wouldn't let this service end unless I invested in the word, amen, that God has given unto me in my life. Hallelujah to God. Mount Pisgah Clyo, amen. Mount Pisgah Independent Methodist Church, amen. And P.O. Box 5, hallelujah, Clyo, Georgia. Come on, you can give right now. Hallelujah to God. Thank you. Thank you so much. Amen. God say, I love a cheerful giver. I love the cheerful giver. Amen. Don't worry about it. Y'all heard it. Amen. Thank you so much, amen, for allowing, amen, this ministry to come in your home and to be a blessing. Remember, make your election sure. Whatever it is, I ain't going to tell you how to vote, but I will tell you that if you don't give Christ your life, he's the best thing that can ever happen to you. God bless you. We love you. May heaven continue to smile upon you.